Hi, Celeste. It's good to have you here.
Thank you. It's good to be here.
Oh,
thanks
for
having me.
Always, always. So let's talk about grow lights, right?
Oh, yes.
Right. So you brought some for us to see. So where would you like to start with this conversation?
Well, let's start with just talking about, you know, what light is.
Okay,
so that
there.
Folks can get
gotcha.
A good understanding of that.
Okay, let's do that.
You know, and it's confusing. This, I had to do some research on this myself. You know, I don't want people to get discouraged. You can be overwhelmed when you get in to, you know, trying to decide what lights you need for what different types of purposes. So I think the best place to start is just at the beginning and talk about what light is.
Let's do it.
So we can talk about light in terms of particles, right? So like photons of light.
Right.
And that's has to do with intensity of light.
Okay.
We can also talk about light in terms of waves, right? Which are measurable.
Okay.
We can measure those in a wavelength. So you may have heard that term before. And when we get into talking about measuring light in wavelengths, that has more to do with like quality of light. So some wavelengths of light are very available and usable by plants.
Okay.
Other wavelengths are not usable by plants.
All right.
So it's important to understand what that means. Plants are going to have different requirements of light, not only in intensity, but also in quality of light at different portions of their life cycle.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, what the lights that you might use for seed starting are going to look different from lights that you might need to sustain a plant through its entire, you know, life cycle, through blooming, through fruiting. When you purchase lights, they're going to have lots of different like numbers and, you know, all these different things on there. So try not to get distracted by all of that. Watts, I feel like wattage that's listed on lights, grow lights in general, can be very confusing to people. That doesn't have anything to do with the growth of the plant. Wattage has to do with how much electricity that bulb is going to pull out through the outlet.
Okay.
There's a really neat publication that I shared a link with you guys.
Good.
Hopefully we're going to share that along with this episode. And it puts it into analogies of light filling up buckets, right? So think of a plant, for example, a plant that is a shade-loving plant would have a smaller light bucket than, say, a plant that would be a sun-loving plant. Their bucket's going to be larger. And those buckets need to be filled in order for that plant to grow and reach its like productive capacity, okay? And it continues through that publication to put into perspective all of these scenarios of filling these light buckets. So not only are we concerned with filling the light bucket for intensity, like our daily light integral. So that's the amount of light that the plant would need in a day for it to grow. Now, depending on the quality of light, that portion of time could be less or more, right? If we're providing it wavelengths that are very usable by that plant, maybe you only need 5 hours of light exposure.
Okay.
If you are unsure of the quality of your light, maybe that time is much longer, right?
Okay.
So what I like to, what I use mostly in-house are lights for starting plants.
Gotcha.
And so let's, we
let's
brought some examples.
Okay, yeah, let's look at those.
We will start right here. This is a four bulb, a fluorescent light, teeny tiny lights.
Yeah.
These are called T5 bulbs. And they're much smaller than what we would think of in a typical fluorescent shop light. Those are T8.
Okay.
Or what those are categorized as. And I feel like the question that we get in an extension most often is, can I use shop lights?
Yeah.
Or do I need LED lights or do I need specific grow lights? And that is a question of light quality. When for starting seeds, we really need to be focusing on light quantity.
Okay.
So we'll talk about some ways that plants can help us pick up on their cues for if they're getting enough light or not. But we can turn some of these lights on and show you, for example.
Let's
start with this big fluorescent four bulb light.
Hey,
see how bright that is?
That is bright.
Right. So we're going to be able to measure the intensity and quality in some cases with light meters.
Okay.
I did not bring a light meter today. But it's important to always use that light meter as an aid to help you see what kind of intensity, what kind of output that you're having with these lights.
Okay,
so a smaller scale version of this, because this is pretty huge, right? That's big. So you've got to have some room to use that. This is what I use for a little tabletop seed starting in my kitchen. It's the same type of bulb. It's a T8, and it's got reflective surfaces here, so that just helps reflect that light back down to the plants. And it comes on a little stand, so that's perfect for putting a flat up underneath here and helping you get some lights going on there to get your plants going. This particular one comes with this stand. It holds it about 6 to 8 inches above the plants, and because that's what it's been rated at.
Okay.
So it has enough output that this doesn't have to be inches from the tops of plants. And this is what I use when I'm getting seedlings going right off the bat. Now, other options are LED lights. So here, I'll just leave it right here and turn it on so we can see it. So this LED light, you can kind of tell it's putting off like a purple cast, and that's because it is supplying multiple wavelengths of light. This is supplying blue wavelengths and red wavelengths.
Okay.
You're gonna see this on a lot of your, you know, grow lights where they are providing specific spectrums of light that are most usable by plants.
Okay.
So this is another great option. The bulbs are super small, they don't use much electricity to run, and they put off very little radiant heat. So, you know, you don't have to worry about the light burning your plants if you have it too close to the plants.
Okay, that's good.
A few other types of lights that we have here, and we would use these for a little bit of a different purpose here. These would be more for if you were trying to grow a plant to its full production.
Wow, look at that.
Right, indoors with all artificial lighting. So this is the blue wavelength of light. I think that you can see that from here for vegetative production. And you also have the ability to swap on a red wavelength in there to get flowering. So that would help promote fruiting and flowering.
So you're saying that the full development of the plant?
Yes, this would be, you know, a type of option that a person might be able to use indoors if they were using, you know, the plant was never gonna be planted outside.
Right.
The first two that I showed, those are my favorites for seed starting.
All right, seed starting.
Seed starting,
okay,
right?
Okay.
They're providing high intensity. We're less concerned about the quality of light because it's all about the amount of light that's hitting those leaves there at the beginning. But once we get into, you know, growing that plant throughout its life cycle, it's gonna need more spectrums of light. And so that's what this type of light is providing right here. This other light right here on this arm, I thought this is pretty cool.
Yeah, that is cool. How about that?
So that's pretty neat. And it has similar bulbs to the one that we just looked at here. But they promote this type of light, I think, mostly for helping overwinter plants. So I know that I have, you know, ferns and different things that I like to try to bring into my garage, overwinter them throughout the year. I don't have a greenhouse to put them in. And this just helps give them some light throughout those winter months. It's not a heat lamp.
Yeah.
I want to clarify, because this could be confusing and people could think that's a heat lamp.
Yeah.
We want to stay away from heat lamps. Heat lamps are not what we need for seed starting or plant growing. They are not providing providing that quality of light nor the intensity of light. So these were just a few of the different types of lights that we wanted to bring and share with y'all today and talk about the different uses and how you might, you know, use those for different types of plants. They're going to tell you if they're getting enough light or not. If they are not receiving the high enough intensity of light, the seedlings, they're going to elongate as they grow. They're going to stretch. They're going to stretch towards light.
Gotcha.
I've seen that sometimes where I've tried to put too many seedling trays underneath a small light. Maybe I only have one bulb or, you know, I even have a fluorescent shop light that has two bulbs.
Okay.
Traditional shop lights would have four bulbs in them, and you can see them. They'll lean this way, and I'll flip the tray, and then the next day they kind of lean this way. So that can be a sign I really need for that size tray. I need to put them under a ballast that has four, you know, four bulbs under it. And so, you know, just taking cues from your plants, yeah. monitor them every day, making sure that you're not getting leaf burn, are, you know, a few of the things that you can do to kind of help you make good decisions about what types of plants and what types of light your plants are really going to find most useful.
Celeste, this was good. Yeah, I like the the buckets of light. So yeah, we're going to focus on quantity.
Yes, for seed
quantity,
starting.
For
quantity.
Seed
quantity
starting.
Of light is the most important. Measuring that intensity. Those photons of light, which are measured in moles,
yeah.
that's important
yes,
to note.
That. Okay.
So when you're using your light meters, PAR, that's another term that you may run into.
Okay.
Photosynthetically active radiation.
Look at you.
Yeah, that's a big
Look
one.
At you.
So
that's
we'll go with
one.
PAR
yeah,
for short.
Let's do that.
So you're gonna see bulbs with ratings for that, and so you know use that as your guide as well.
Good deal, Celeste. So there's your science course, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you much, Celeste. We appreciate that.
You're welcome.
All right. Thanks for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. To find out more information on this topic, just click on the familyplotgarden.com link in the description.